Lubricants having many important properties: neutralization number, saponification number, aniline point, flash point, fire point, like that. Viscosity, viscosity index. Neutralization number. Neutralization number means acidity or alkalinity of the lubricating oil. Actually, we discussed acidic lubricants, I mean basic lubricants also, like that. Acidity or alkalinity of the lubricating oil is determined in terms of its neutralization number. That is neutralization number of that particular lubricant. That particular lubricant. Determination of acidity is more common. I mean, it is expressed as an acidic value. Acidic, suppose that lubricant is the acid, we are explaining that as a with the acidic value. Acidic value. Or it is defined as the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide. Because lubricant is the acid, we are titrating with potassium hydroxide. Potassium hydroxide is the base. Potassium hydroxide is the base. Number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize all the free acid acidic groups present in 1 gram of lubricating oil. 1 gram of lubricating oil. Acidic number of the acidic value of the lubricating oil is number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize all the free acid or acidic groups present in 1 gram of the lubricating oil. Even, I mean, most carefully refined oil also having some acidity due to the presence of minute amount of organic constituents. So like that, alkalinity value is amount of, I mean, number of milligrams of HCl or H2SO4 required to neutralize all the pre-OH ions, all the hydroxide ions present in the 1 gram of the lubricating oil. That is the neutralization number. Neutralization number for acidic lubricants, mostly acidic lubricants are there. Acidic lubricants, that is the acidic value. If suppose basic lubricants are there, that is the basic value. Basic value. Saponification number. Saponification of the oil or lubricating oil is the, I mean, number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to saponify, number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to saponify 1 gram of the oil. 1 gram of the oil. Actually, this is determined by the reflecting a known quantity of the oil, lubricating oil, with a known excess of standard potassium hydroxide solution. Saponification number is the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to saponify 1 gram of the oil. Like same acidic value. Acidic value. Actually, animal and vegetable oil undergo saponification, but mineral oils do not. Mineral oil, unsaturated oils, whatever it may be there, it is treated with that. Further, most of the animal and vegetable oils process their own characteristic saponification value. as per their requirements, as per their characteristics. Annealing point. The annealing point of an oil is oil in the sense lubricating oil. Okay, defined as the minimum equilibrium solution temperature for equal volumes of annealing and oil sample. Minimum annealing point is the minimum equilibrium solution temperature for equal volumes of annealing and oil sample. Minimum equilibrium solution temperature for equal volumes of annealing and oil sample, lubricating oil sample, is known as annealing point. Aromatic hydrocarbons have high tendency to dissolve natural and synthetic rubbers. This tendency can be determined on the basis of annealing point. A higher annealing point means lower percentage of hydrocarbons. Hence, having higher annealing point is desirable. Annealing point is determined by thoroughly mixing equal volumes of annealing and oil sample. In a tube and heating the mixture until a homogeneous solution is obtained. This is allowed to cool at a specified rate until the two phases just separated out. The temperature corresponding to this particular observation is reported as an annealing point. Cloud point and pour point. Actually, the cloud point is temperature at which this the crystallization of solids in the hydrocarbon in the form of a cloud or haze first becomes noticeable. Suppose if we are any organic compounds, anything, phenol or whatever it may be. If we are overheated, what is happening? It's completely clear. Then slowly it is cooling. What is happening? Darkness, little dark. Because at certain temperatures only it will be clear solution. Below that temperature it will be some like this, lubricants like solution. Cloud like solution. So that is the cloud point of the oil, lubricating oil. Suppose how we can know the cloud point of the any particular lubricant come overheated. That lubricant is overheated and allow it cool whenever crystallization started. Crystallization of solids in the form of cloud or haze becomes noticeable, started. That is known as cloud point. When the oil is cooled in a standard apparatus at standard rate, the pour point is reverse. The temperature at which the oil just ceases to flow when cooled at a standard rate in a standard apparatus. Pour point is the temperature at which the oil just ceases to flow. That is pour point. Cloud point is the temperature at which crystallization started or cloudy or haziness is formed, noticed. The pour point has greater significance for lubricating oil because it determines the suitability of hydraulic oil, for low temperature installations. actually refrigerator plants, aircraft engines has some important examples which may be required to start and operate at sub-zero temperatures too. Refrigerators, aircraft, engines. Temperature may be varies. It has to start at zero minus levels also. Hence, 4-point plays vital role. Next, flash point and fire point. The flash point of an oil is defined as the minimum temperature at which the oil gives off sufficient vapor to ignite momentarily. To give flash. The minimum temperature at which the oil gives sufficient vapor to ignite momentarily when a flame of standard dimensions. is brought nearer the surface of the oil. That is the flash. The fire point of an oil is the lowest temperature at which the vapors of the oil burn continuously. Firing. The lowest temperature at which the vapors of the oil burn continuously for at least 5 seconds. When the standard flame is brought nearer the surface of the lubricating oil. That is the fire point. Lowest minimum temperature requires the vapors of the lubricating oil burns continuously at least 5 seconds is the fire point. The minimum temperature required for lubricating oil gives off sufficient vapor to ignite is known as flash point. The lubricating oil should have flash point that is reasonably above its working temperature. If it is below, what is happening? Flash will be started. This ensures safety against fire hazards during usage, storage, and transport. The flash point of lubricating oil can be determined by Penske Martin's apparatus. Next one is the viscosity and viscosity index. What is meant by viscosity? Viscosity is the important property of the lubricating oil. Viscosity, oiliness. The formation of fluid film of a lubricant between the friction surface and the generation of frictional heat under particular conditions of load, bearing spread, and lubricant supply mostly depend on the viscosity of the lubricant and to some extent on its oiliness. So viscosity of the oil is should be very low. Viscosity of the oil is very low. The fluid lubricant film cannot be maintained. Viscosity is the flow of resistance, right? Withstand resistance to flow. Viscosity of the oil is very low. What is happening? It may not maintain. Fluid film lubricant may not be, film cannot be maintained between the moving surfaces. The viscosity of lubricating oil is very high. Excessive friction would be occurs. Hence should be moderate. If very low, it may not maintain. It cannot be maintained a film. If it is very high, excessive friction, actually why we are using the lubricant? To avoid the friction, wear and tear in between moving or sliding surfaces. but if it is very high, viscosity is very high, but it would occur, friction would occur due to sharing of oil. Sharing of oil. Viscosity index. Actually, viscosity is the measure of the internal resistance to the motion of a fluid and is mainly due to the forces of cohesion between the fluid molecules. Forces of cohesion between the fluid molecules. Absolute viscosity can be defined as the tangential force per unit area. It required to maintain a unit velocity or gradient between two parallel planes in the fluid unit distance apart. The units of absolute viscosity are eta, a centimeter gram second. I mean, in the CZS system. Poise and centipoise. And poise is equal to 1 dyne per second per square centimeter. 1 poise is equal to 1 dyne per second per square centimeter. The viscosity of water at 20 degrees centigrade is about a centipoise. What is the viscosity index? The ratio of absolute viscosity to density for any fluid is known as a absolute kinematic viscosity. Absolute viscosity can be defined as the tangential force per unit area required to maintain a unit velocity gradient between two parallel planes. Units for absolute viscosity is the eta, poise or centipoise. The ratio of absolute viscosity to density for any fluid is known as absolute kinematic viscosity. Absolute kinematic viscosity. It's denoted by eta. Its units are stokes and centistokes. Absolute viscosity units are eta, poise, centipoise. Absolute kinematic viscosity units are stokes or centistokes. V is absolute kinematic viscosity is equal to absolute dynamic viscosity eta by density of the fluid. Viscosity will be measured by Redwood viscometer, Engler's viscometer, U-tube viscometers like that. What is the viscosity index? Viscosity index is the, viscosity of an oil decreases with increase in temperature. While we are increasing the temperature, viscosity of the oil is decreasing. As a result of decrease in intermolecular attraction due to expansion. When temperature is increasing, what is happening? Intermolecular attractions will be expanding. Due to that, flow will be easily, or viscosity will be decreased. Hence, it is always necessary to state the temperature. Temperature is mandatory to, at which temperature we are measuring, at which the viscosity is determined. Viscosity index of oil is viscosity at 100 degree Fahrenheit of Gulf oil standard, which has the same viscosity at 210 Fahrenheit also, as that of oil under test, minus Vx, viscosity of the oil under test, Vx in the sense viscosity of the oil under test by VL minus VH. VH is the viscosity at 100 degree centigrade Fahrenheit. 100 degree Fahrenheit. Into 100. Viscosity index of the oil under test is equal to VL minus VX by VL minus VH. VL minus VH. VL is equal to viscosity at 100 degrees Fahrenheit of Gulf oil stranded, which has same viscosity at 210 Fahrenheit also. VX is the viscosity of the oil under test. VH is the viscosity of the 100 degree Fahrenheit of the Pennsylvanian stranded oil. Pennsylvanian stranded oil. This one also having the same viscosity at 210 Fahrenheit as that of under the test. Under the test. These are the important properties of lubricating. Mechanical stability. Mechanical stability of the lubricating oil will be explained by four valves extreme pressure test. This is the important test for mechanical test to judge the suitability of the lubricant under conditions of high pressure. In this test, lubricants under test is powdered in the machine containing four balls like this. This side two and then other side two is there. Here the upper ball is rotated and the lower three balls are stationary. This is rotated. Remaining three are stationary. The load is gradually increased. The ball is withdrawn and examined at specific intervals for scale formation. Scale formation. Under a given load, the ball bearings after the test comes out clean if the lubricant desirable. When the load is progressively increased, the liberated heat wells the ball together. Here the lubricant is said to have a completely failed. Hence, this test enables us to determine the maximum load that can be carried safely by a lubricant. By a lubricant. So, mechanical strength of the mechanical stability of the lubricant can be explained by four ball extreme pressure lubricants. Four ball extreme pressure lubricants. These are the important properties of lubricating oils.